Mike was curious about the height of the Petronas Towers and decided to measure it indirectly while he was in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. He used a 2-meter model of the building that he found in a gift shop and measured the length of the shadow of the model to be 0.8 meters. Then he measured the length of the shadow of the Petronas Towers and found it to be 180 meters. What is the height of the Petronas Towers? This is a similar triangle problem. So first thing I want to do is I want to draw a triangle that represents the small tower from the gift shop. So he bought a toy tower, and that was 2 meters tall, and it cast a shadow of 0.8 meters. Okay, so this is going to be a right angle right here. And I can enclose this with a hypotenuse. All right, so this is the triangle that represents the model. Now for the actual tower, now this is not going to be proportionally correct. He wants to know the height of it. I'll call that X. And he measured the shadow and found that it was 180 meters. Okay, and again, the tower would form a right angle with the shadow. Okay, so in closing that, you'll see that we have similar triangles, and I can use direct proportion in this case. So I want to set this up as a proportion, and I'm going to put the height in the numerators, okay? And I want to make sure that I put the correct length here. I don't want to put the 180 down here. Okay, I'm going smaller to larger. So in my denominator, I want smaller to larger. Okay, so I'm going to put 0.8 in that denominator and 180 in the second denominator. Now that I have it set up as a proportion, I could go ahead and cross multiply. That's a shortcut for solving a proportion problem. So that's going to be 0.8x, or 0.8 times x is equal to 2 times 180. So cleaning this up a little bit, I have 0.8 times x is equal to 360. And then the last step is to divide both sides by 0.8. So I'll have 360 divided by 0.8. And doing that division in my calculator, I got 450, and the units is meters.